You just had your egg retrieval. You got 8 eggs and are pretty happy with yourself. Then you go online and you see somebody else got 18 eggs and another got 28 eggs. Why do some people get more eggs than others? Stay tuned and I will explain. The number of eggs that you can get during an IVF egg retrieval depends on 4 factors. Number 1, the number of eggs remaining in your ovaries. Number 2, the ability of your ovaries to respond to fertility medications. Number 3, the dose of medication used to stimulate your ovaries. And number 4, your anatomy. The number of eggs remaining in the ovaries is called ovarian reserve. The eggs in the ovaries are formed before birth. During the time that a fetus is developing, the number of eggs in the ovaries are increasing. But about 3 months before birth, all of the egg production stops. Then the eggs start degenerating. This causes the number of eggs remaining to drop. As a result, as women get older, the number of eggs remaining in the ovaries gets lower and lower. As a general rule, older women will have lower ovarian reserve compared to younger women. Sometimes, however, younger women can also have low reserve. Women with low reserve do not get as many eggs during IVF, on average, as women with a normal reserve. Therefore, measuring ovarian reserve is an extremely important group of tests to have before doing IVF. I talk about that extensively in this video. People with a high reserve can get a larger number of eggs during IVF. One example of a group of people with high ovarian reserve are people with PCOS. People with PCOS have more eggs and follicles than other people of a similar age. As a result, they respond better to fertility medications and therefore produce a higher number of eggs. Some people with a normal reserve of eggs may still not respond well to the medications we use for IVF. To understand why this could happen, we need to understand how fertility medications work. Each egg in the ovary is surrounded by a group of cells called granulosa cells. The granulosa cells have protein receptors on their surface. Hormones, such as FSH, which stands for follicle stimulating hormone, will attach to the receptor. After the FSH attaches, a signal is sent into the cell. These signals tell the cell to do a variety of things. In some people, these hormone receptors may not work correctly. One possible cause of a malfunctioning receptor are mutations in the gene that makes the receptor. Scientists have discovered a small fraction of the mutations which cause the receptors not to work well, but there are likely hundreds of others. Some of these mutations may cause only a mild problem with the receptor. Some may be more severe. If the receptor does not work correctly, then the ovaries may not respond to the medications as well, and those people may not get as many eggs during the egg retrieval. As of right now, we don't have an easy way to identify if a person is going to have this problem. In general, there is a relationship between how much medication is given and how many eggs are retrieved, but this isn't true 100% of the time. For example, in women with poor reserve or in those who have resistant ovaries, increasing the dose of medications may not increase the number of eggs. Even if the ovaries respond to fertility medications, the doctor still has to be able to get them out. A person who has ovaries that are difficult to access may end up with some eggs left behind in the ovary. This can happen in people who have scar tissue, which is pulling the ovaries into an inaccessible position, or masses like fibroids might get in the way. Being overweight can also make it more difficult to get to the ovaries to retrieve eggs. One final point. There is a large amount of variation in the ovaries from 1 month to the next. It is possible to get more eggs on one attempt and less on another. Watch this video for more information about that. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. There are a number of variables that can result in differences in your ability to get eggs during IVF. Some of these you might know about ahead of time, but some you may not. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.